You are joining me on a crazy busy week because as of 1 week today, I will be installing my latest collection in a new exhibition. So it's 1 week away. How many pieces do I currently have ready to go? Zero. It's zero. So that's great. What happened was, found out about it months ago. I thought, that's perfect. I've been thinking about it, you know, I'm not going to lie. I haven't done nothing. I've been doing a lot of prep. I designed the fabric that I'm going to use. So that's ready. I'll open that in a sec. I've not opened it yet. Hope it's okay. Yeah, and then I just thought we had bits to do in the house. We were renovating our living room, which is now done. Happy days. But have I done any exhibition work? No. So yeah, it's going to be a mad scramble now. I hope my curator doesn't watch this. Becky, if you do, I'm sorry. This is just my process, apparently. So yeah, my plan now is, like I said, I've organised everything. I've got the prep work done. I literally now just need to sit on a sewing machine and churn it out. I've done all the legwork, you know. I've got a little bit of line work to do still, but I'll literally do that this morning and then we're cracking. So a bit about the exhibition. It is 2 weekends in September in my hometown of Hull, East Yorkshire. It is in a gorgeous Georgian building, which is a National Trust property, and the National Trust are opening it for the Heritage Open weekends, which are 2 weekends. So me and 8 other artists are putting our work on display in said building, and I think it will be really nice. So some of the work is inspired by the building and some of the work is just stuff that I've been really into lately, like a lot of botanicals and stuff like that. It'll be install day a week today, which will be the Thursday, and then it runs Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and then Friday, Saturday, Sunday again, and then it's over. Hopefully I'm going to sell some pieces. Whatever I don't sell will go on my website afterwards. And I'm also, for people that can't make it, I'm going to do a live, not a live, I'm going to do an online exhibition preview as well on my website. So, and there's going to be a video on YouTube of the exhibition. So stay tuned for that. It's all coming to you. My plan for today is finish the line work. Let me show you some of the imagery I've got. This is like a little mood board that I've done of some mini pieces I'm gonna make. The exhibition is called Underlock and Ceres, and she is the goddess of, what's the word? Agriculture. And she's, there's a statue of her in the building. That's the building, by the way. So that's why she's linked to it. National Trust property, and then also some other bits that I've been digging, and a little version of her. So I'm gonna do, yeah, like I said, do some mini pieces based off of those, and then I've also printed some pictures of the building. There she is, she's in a cage. Apparently that's standard National Trust policy to do that so she doesn't get stolen, but apparently they may be taking those bars off for the opening weekend, so that's exciting. And here is a photo of the details of the stairs, which I thought was cute, so I'm probably going to embroider them. And then I'm also doing a big piece of the building itself, see, but fabric. Let's look at it. So it came, and I literally opened it to just check that that's what it was, and then I left it because I can't really remember, I was so busy. This was like a few weeks ago. Anyway. They fold it with the pattern inside. It's so cruel. Oh, look. Oh, yes. That is chic. Oh, yeah. I'm chuffed with that. I think I just ordered 1 metre because I'm not going to make every single piece with this. And I think I've got some from my last collection as well that I'm going to use. Because it all ties together, and then I'm going to do some just on plain calico like I usually do. So, happy with that. Wednesday. No, it's not Tuesday. It's Friday. Oh my God. It's Friday. So there's less than 1 week till the install. Yesterday I did this piece and this piece, and that's it. And these are two of a mini series of five pieces that I'm doing. So that's not great progress from yesterday, and I would have liked to have done more. But I did do all the line work, and that does take a long time. So at least now I can churn out a good few things like in succession because they're ready to go. But what's throwing a spanner in midair today is that I'm doing a workshop tomorrow, a full day workshop, and I just need to prep some last minute bits. So it won't take long, but it's just a different thing that I have to do now rather than just churn stuff out on the machine. So yes, I'm going to do that, and then tomorrow I will try and bring you with me for the workshop. I'm not sure how much filming I'll be able to do while I'm there because I think it's going to be quite busy, but you know, we'll try. And then from there, Sunday, I am actually going to maybe try and get some sewing done in the evening, and then we're into Monday and it'll be a full on week of prep. No longer attached. I don't know if I have any more. Also, why did that just happen? Why? It's actually bent ever so slightly. Yeah, that's bent. Joy! Okay, so thankfully, I mean maybe, thankfully, I had these Singer needles from my other sewing machine because I used to break the needle on my Singer all the time because it's not made for doing stuff like this. So I'm going to try and put one of these in, but I don't actually know if it'll fit. Let's hope so, because otherwise I actually don't know what I'm going to do because I'm going to have to go... just drop them on all the packet. Yeah, if this don't fit, I'm gonna have to go to Hobbycraft and hope they have one, or otherwise I'm gonna have to order one online, and I really haven't got time for that. So that's the new one with the red tip, and that's the old one. So they're like the same length, and they've both got the top of the needle has got like a rounded side and then a flat side. So that's the flat side, and then it goes round into this rounded side. So, I mean, I think they're slightly different, but I think it might work. Oh, let's see. Right. Put that down. Well, it's gone in. Should it go in higher than that? Let's tighten it up. Well, it's gone in. It's gone in. I don't know if it's supposed to have gone high because I can see quite a lot of the red section still in it. Let's re-thread and test it. Also, I still don't know why that just happened, because I was literally just sewing a straight line. Ah, stop it. Oh, I've got very tangled. There we go. Yeah, so how that's caused that to bend and then snap, I do not know. Right. This is only like a banner that I'm doing for the workshop. It doesn't have to be super neat. So we'll carry on this because I don't think it can go, even if it does snap or something again, it obviously doesn't go too far wrong. And that has snapped in there and it's not even affected the stitching. So let's try it, shall we? Please work. I mean, the tension seems a bit off. Yeah, the tension's off, but it is working. It's not falling out, so I think I just need to faff with the tension and we'll see. Okay, I got to the end. No more snapping and good tension. So, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Honestly, it's so not my look to have the thing that I need when it breaks ready to go. Usually, like if I run out of thread, I haven't got any more thread because I'm not usually that kind of person. But I've actually got 3 needles still in there and I've got a whole other packet with 5 in. So that is like never heard of before. Genius. Thank you past me for ordering way too many needles. I've never replaced one on this machine ever, which is probably a bad thing now I'm saying that. It's probably not sharp at all. Anyway, live and learn. Ta-da! So the plan for that is, if you watched the last vlog that I did where I did one of these workshops, I'll link it. The plan is that people are going to be doing their own printing blocks and they can print on paper and take it home, but they can also print their block on this big piece, so by the end of the day we'll have one of everyone's on there. So nice. It is 10 to 7. I finished that set of 5. So I've got the bee. They're a bit of a random set. The wildflowers I'd already done and the National Trust I'd already done. So today I did the bee. I did the tiny house. Those railings killed me off. And then I did this. So there's still some stitches to snip off, but I'd do that in front of the surf. There's no point wasting like daylight time doing that. And then I've done so much of this. So I've done this much of this and there's only that little bit to go, but I'm gonna clock off for the night. So yeah, workshop tomorrow. It is Monday, install is Thursday. Didn't do any sewing over the weekend. Didn't really take any pictures at that festival. But I have just finished this, which is details of the stairs. So that's done.
And now I'm going to do this, which is going to melt my brain cells. I just know it. I shouldn't have saved this till last. This staircase looks a mess. I'm a bit concerned about that. But on the original photo that I took, you can't really see it because it's so dark. So I'm struggling to like draw it out now because I don't really know what it looked like. So I'm basing it off what they look like. But bigger, I don't know. I'm just hoping in stitch it'll look fine. And then I'm doing this on a plain calico because I think it will look mental busy if I do that on a marbled fabric. But then I thought, then there's going to be like one random calico piece surrounded by marbled pieces. So I'm also going to do this on a calico piece. So at least there's two similar. Because I was thinking about doing this piece anyway. I had it on reserve and it's only small. So I'll quickly, after I've done this, churn this one out. And then tomorrow I'm going to do tidying up and stuff and like trim the threads, get ready to mount them all. I need to go to B&Q tonight to get wood to mount them onto. Wednesday my car's in for MOT, so that's going to be my mounting day. And then Thursday we're here. So I need to get this finished today or tomorrow at the latest. Oh, help. I've just realised I haven't ordered any business cards. Why? Why? So I might have to now quickly try and order some because at least, because the exhibition starts Friday, but it's on next weekend as well. So at least maybe if they don't come this weekend, they'll be here in time for next weekend. I just can't. Why is my brain like this? Ugh. Just when you think you're like on the home stretch. Anyway. it's Wednesday, it's the day before install. As you can see, I'm not in my house. The reason for that is my car had its MOT today, so I take it to the garage, but the garage is not near my house. So then leaving it there and getting back to my house would be a pain. However, my parents live very close, so I packed up all my stuff, dropped my car off, walked to my parents, and I've been set up here ever since. And I just wanted to really crack on, but it has sort of paid off, although it's 10 to 1, so we're getting through the day now and I've still got loads to do. I've finished this piece. Those banisters, they absolutely drove me almost blind. And as you saw yesterday, I really left that bit to last. And then I've also just knocked out this, which is the statue that is on display in the house that the exhibition's in. So that's like a nice little tie, but it also works like as its own thing. So that's all my pieces done. I'm done for pieces. I just now need to trim the threads, mount them, and for the ones, the mini pieces, I'm going to be hanging them on dowels, so I need to do a little bit of construction so they look super neat. So that's it in theory, but like I said, it is now 10 to 1. So we'll see how I get on, but really it all needs doing. I'm not sure what time install is tomorrow, but obviously there's the opportunity to finish some stuff off in the morning. Although I'd rather not. I'd rather just be able to leave today and just be like, it's done. My car passed its MOT, by the way. I dropped it off first thing and they just rang me about half an hour ago. So at least that's going well. So I've trimmed the threads on everything. Now I'm going to mount the ones that are going on frames. So I've got these wooden frames. This is what I usually do for exhibition pieces, mount them like canvas style. So that one's going on there. And then I've got these two as well. So I just need to get a bit of backing fabric cut so you can't see the stitching on the back. And then I just staple it to the edges. Obviously they all need a good iron as well. And then these mini pieces are actually going to get sewn up and made like into like more hangings than canvas style. So I'll do that at home because it's now 20 to 3 and I live at the other side of town, so I don't want to get caught in like traffic. So I'll literally just do these and mount them. And that's going to take me at least half an hour anyway. But then they're done and I just have to do the hangings when I get home.
is install day. We've made it. I am actually really calm and relaxed right now, which is surprising because I actually still have things to finish off. Last night when I got back, I started doing these little banners. I'm so happy with them. Look how cute and neat they are. I wanted to do like a little sort of textile wall hanging, but without it looking too crafty, which is always the risk that you run with textile art. But my problem is I accidentally make things look crafty because I don't ever use a ruler or measure anything or do anything that neatly. However, how cute is that? So I've got some little hooks that are going to go in the side of there that will hold the string, and it's just a dowel in each end. So I've done three of those. They'll be and flowers, and then I've got two more to do because they're a set of five, and that's it. The business cards that I ordered on Monday are coming today. Miracle! So I'm really pleased about that. So they're going to come before lunch, hopefully. So I'm literally just going to finish these tapestry hangings, wait for those, and then I'm going to go as soon as that's all done. So happy days! I'm excited! I'm going to take you with me for the install, and then that will be the end of this vlog. I'm going to be doing a video that's like super posh, exhibition show via video for all you guys that aren't local. You will still get the full exhibition experience, so I hope you enjoy that. Anyway, so let's crack on, because as soon as those business cards get here, I want to be going. So I'm going to try and get everything ready before they do. Yeah, it's like the hottest September day. So I've got these three boards. One, two, three. So I'm just gonna space everything out. I'm gonna put those three in a vertical line down there. I'm gonna put my series of five in a vertical line for there, and then just that one on its own, because it's a showstopper. So I've just been downstairs and it all looks really good. There's four artists downstairs, four artists upstairs. So yeah, I'll show you around. So this guy's a potter. He's brought all his stuff, but he needs like plinths and stuff. I'm there, and then Becky, who's also the curator, has got some next to me and then some round here. Also cute. Everyone's done quite a lot and it makes me think I've not done enough. That's a drawing of the house. How nice. And then Claire West, who's a printmaker.
Okay, so I am done hanging. However, bit of an issue with these because they're not very light, so they're not sat flat. See how much that one's poking out. So this could do like a weight on the bottom to keep more flat. I don't know how that's gonna work. And these are a little bit like it, and obviously this is hanging loose. I don't know if they want like cutting off or not, so I'm gonna leave it. But that one looks nice. Beautiful. So the exhibition's all installed, and actually as I film this we've just done the first weekend and it went really well. I forgot to film it, but I secured that hanging wire at the bottom with pins, so it's fully taut. It looks really nice. So yeah, it's gone really well, and my exhibition, I'm going to do a whole proper collection sort of review video, and that'll be coming next week, so keep an eye out for that. But in the meantime, check out the description. I've listed my fellow artists down there. I've wrote a blog post about the exhibition, which you can go check out. Information about the house, except it's all down there. So go check that out. Don't forget to subscribe. Like I say, there's more to come about the exhibition and just more fun stuff in general, as always. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.